Go. Okay, let's start. Settle down, I'm starting the class. I'm not discussing the problem right now. We have to derive the equation from motion. We don't have time, so I'll take it seriously. Okay. Stop talking, please. Okay. So we will derive it using the velocity tangram. Last class we interpreted different possible ways the velocity tangram can change. So let's draw it. So let's take a simple case. Now one thing you need to remember, Rishikesh, will you please stop talking? You don't have to speak in return, please.
Sorry, sir.
I started the video also, class is going on, stop talking.
Sorry, sir.
So now we are going to do the derivation for equations of motion. But you need to understand in physics, whichever equations you use, you need to know under what conditions they are valid. When can you apply them? You can't apply any equation for any situation. Everything has a limitation. Right? So these equations are valid only for constant acceleration. That means if the body's acceleration is changing, then you can't apply these equations of motion which we will be deriving. You getting it? If its acceleration is no longer constant, you can't apply this equation.
So the lights come.
Please be seated and don't disturb the class. And one more thing to remember is each equation can be used only for motion along one dimension. But then you will find that later on we will use the same equations even to describe motion in 2D and 3D. So there what we do is we resolve that motion along one direction at a time and apply the equation for motion along that direction. You will learn it in higher grades. For example, if I throw an object, it will go in a parabolic path, right? Same equations will be used, but at one time you will analyze the motion along x-axis, that is the horizontal path, and another time you will apply the same equation separately along the vertical motion. So you will only track the vertical position, how it changes with time, or how the horizontal position changes with time. Same time, you cannot track the actual position, which is like this. So these equations cannot track motion in 2D or 3D, they will only track motion along one dimension. Clear? So let's, for your syllabus, you need to only know how to use these equations for tracking motion along one dimension.
So will we do 2D or 3D in near future?
11th only is there in your syllabus, but after class you can learn whenever you want. Or you can take a book and read on your own. Now let's start. So let's take a simple case where it starts with some non-zero velocity so that it covers all possible values of velocity. And it has a constant acceleration. So slope of velocity time graph is acceleration. So if acceleration is constant, slope has to be constant. That means it has to be a straight line. Right? So if it's a straight line, so this is the time is 0 seconds here. So at initial time, whatever is the velocity, let's call it U. In American textbook, they call it V initial, VI. They also call it VI. So instead of using a variable with a suffix, it makes it look more complicated at your age. So we'll just call it U.
So what is VI?
VI is V initial, that's one way of using the variables in foreign terms of textbooks. But we will just follow one simple symbol. U is initial velocity. After U, V will be the next alphabet in English. So this will be represent final velocity. Initial velocity, final velocity.
So can we just write VI and VF?
Different people have different preferences. You should be smart enough to accept whatever we decide. Now let's use U for initial, V for final, store it in your memory, let's proceed. So after some time, T, okay, let's say the velocity became v. Okay, so the time interval, so the time interval is this delta t is going to be t minus 0, which is t seconds. Agree? During this time interval, what is the change in velocity? Final velocity
minus
initial velocity, which is v minus t. Okay? Change in velocity is the velocity value at a later time. So later time is this point, right hand side of the time axis. At that time the velocity was v. Initial velocity is at the earlier time, the velocity was u. Change in velocity is v minus u. Okay, now I want to find displacement of this object when it traveled during this time interval. So now in this graph the information about displacement is hidden. In what property of graph?
So delta v to t.
So every graph you see has two properties. One is called slope, the other is called area under the graph. So area under the graph is the area between the horizontal axis and the actual curve. In this case the actual curve is this black straight line. This is the horizontal axis. So the area is this whole part, triangle plus rectangle. So what information does it represent?
So displacement.
Displacement. So if you are not able to see how it is displacement, let's take a simpler case where you have time and the velocity is constant. Let us say 10 meter per second, just to make it more easy to visualize. If an object is going at a constant velocity for some time, let us say 5 seconds, and so this is the time value, time is 5 seconds. It went at a constant speed of 10 meter per second. So Shashwat, if I tell you that an object moves at a constant speed of 10 meter per second for 5 seconds, how do you find the total displacement? It went in a straight line. Displacement is, how do you calculate displacement? Okay, how do you find velocity? Velocity is displacement by time. So displacement is velocity multiplied with time. So velocity is constant value throughout the time interval. So this is the length and this is the breadth. So when you do velocity with time, in this graph, this is the v value. So this is the velocity and this is the time value. This is the time. So velocity into time is, this is like breadth of the rectangle, and this is
length
of the rectangle.
So,
1 minute. So velocity into time gives you breadth into length, which is area of rectangle, which is area under the graph.
So what will be the unit?
So unit, you can see velocity unit is what?
Meter per second.
So the unit also matches with that of
10 to 5
displacement.
So question.
1 minute. So area under the velocity versus time graph denotes displacement. Slope of velocity versus time graph denotes acceleration. Clear? Now ask your doubt.
Sir, in that sense, if we multiply delta t into delta v, will we get the area, will we get the displacement?
No. Because see, here it was rectangle. Here it was rectangle.
No, but the formula is v into t.
No. Area under the graph represents displacement. This was a simple case where you had a straight line graph and the area was given by length into breadth. You got the entire area under the graph. Entire area under the graph is the displacement. In this simple case, it was this v into t. But here, v multiplied by t would be this big area. This red rectangle's area. That is not area under the graph. Area under the graph is area of this triangle plus area of this rectangle. Are you getting it?
Got it.
Area of rectangle plus area of triangle is the area under the graph. This will be the displacement in this case. So our goal is to find displacement. So we have to find the area of this region. We can find it in different ways. Each way will give you a new equation, which you can use to solve problems. So let's do that now. I'll erase this part. So now, we want to find displacement. We will call displacement as x. So displacement is x. It means final position minus initial position. Instead of writing it like this, we just represent it by x. Clear till now?
So what is x?
Displacement.
Yeah. So it will be area under
graph.
Velocity time graph. So it will be area of triangle plus area of rectangle. This is one way, okay? So area of triangle is what? Half into base. This base is time and multiplied with height. Height is V minus U.
Delta.
V minus U.
Delta.
We know the initial velocity. Let us say we know the final velocity, it would be like this. Plus, area of this rectangle is?
Ut.
This is time and this is U.
Ut.
So Ut. Okay? So let's keep it here for now. And before we proceed further, here let us go by definition. Acceleration. A represents acceleration. In a velocity time graph, acceleration is given by
slope
of the graph. So slope of the graph. So it would be delta V by delta T, which is V minus U by T. Agreed? So V minus U equals what? What?
AT.
You could also write it as V equals U plus AT. This is the commonly referred to form. We will call this first equation of motion.
It's
coming from definition.
One second.
Vedha, anything, any confusion? V is the final velocity, U is the initial velocity, A is the acceleration, T is the time interval.
So
if an object starts with initial velocity U and it travels with acceleration A for a time T, the speed will increase from U.
Is this the question? Is this the last question?
No.
This is totally different.
This is a derivation of equations of motion for object traveling at in a straight line with constant acceleration. What is your question?
Sir, to determine the slope of the graph, so we need to give you two coordinates by the mathematics.
They won't give you anything. You can get a graph, you pick two points on that straight line graph, which are as far away as possible.
So we'll have the coordinates, right?
Obviously, you will be able to read the coordinates from the graph. Then find the rise by run. That will give you the acceleration value.
So they can ask us.
Don't ask me what they can ask. Yeah. We can ask in any way. Understand the concept. You decide how you can ask yourself and try to make sure you know how to answer it.
Sir, laws of motion can only apply for constant acceleration.
Not laws of motion, they are different entirely. Equations of motion.
So we were solving the displacement.
These equations of motion can be only applied for constant acceleration.
This equation of motion is only for?
Yeah. All the equations which we are going to derive today are valid for constant acceleration because see the graph which we are using to derive here. The graph has a constant
velocity.
Only if the slope is constant, these equations can be derived. So if you can't apply it if the slope is changing. Are you getting it? If the slope is changing in your problem, these equations cannot be derived from that.
They won't be constant.
Yeah, if you have a straight line, which means constant slope, only then you can derive. So this first one, so this is the first step actually. I should have started here and then come here. But since I saw this, I started here, then I realized I should start from here. This is the first step. Slope by definition, you start and get your first equation. Then second equation of motion, what you will do is, actually this is supposed to be third, I'm very sorry. I should have come here third, then it makes a good sequence. Okay? So you want me to derive this here and then move to second or?
No,
so
second then third.
Second then third?
Yes, sir.
So then what we'll do is, let me erase this for now. This area under the graph you want to find, right?
Yes.
So we'll find it by making this area, dividing it into two triangles. Triangle 1, triangle 2.
And triangle
3. No third triangle, just two triangles.
Even that
is this is triangle 2. Please don't argue among yourself. Nishiket, don't respond to others if they are provoking you. This is the triangle 2, this is the triangle 1. Okay? So, in the first equation, there was no displacement anywhere. Now you want to find displacement. So, displacement is area under VT graph, which is going to be area of triangle 1 plus area of triangle 2. Clear? AR means area, short form. So now tell me, Kshitij, area of triangle 1, half into base into height. So what should be the variables? Half
UT
into base is time. Height is u, so half ut plus area of this bigger triangle, you can take the height to be this perpendicular.
That's
this is the base.
Half a into half.
Come on, then, yes.
Half a into v.
Very good. This entire base is equal to the entire length from 0 to v. Everyone understood till here?
Yeah.
So half vt.
So we can take half t common.
So take half common.
Half t common.
U plus yeah, half t common. So the actual final formula is u plus v by 2 multiplied with time, which is called as average speed multiplied by time. V with a line above it is called average speed. V bar. It's a notation in physics. If you put V bar,
what's the notation?
If you put a line above a symbol, it means the average value. If you say V bar, mean velocity, average velocity. You just think, if the speed is increasing at a constant rate from U to V, the average is initial plus final by 2. It will work only if the slope is constant in between.
So isn't the height of the first triangle U?
No, half into base into height. I just wrote it in U in height into base.
You mean to VT there?
UT. This is U, this is V. Clear? So it's U plus V by 2. It's an average of two speeds, right? You've got two marks in two different subjects. One in 70, one is say 100. Average is sum of the two divided by 2. So this is sum of the two speeds divided by 2. So it's an average speed. So suppose I give you a problem where I tell you the average speed and ask you to find that displacement in time t. You can directly multiply average speed with the time, you will get the displacement. Or if you know only initial speed, final speed, then you can still find the displacement. U plus V by 2. 1 minute. So, note this as equation of motion number 2. Okay? So, to summarize, how did we get the second equation? We divided the area under the graph into two triangles and added their area. Simple? What's your question?
So, that's a general question. So, when you write half into UT plus half into VT, so half into UT is for triangle 1.
Yes.
And half into VT is for triangle 2.
Yes.
So, when you compare the height, because when we see triangle 2, they are like 2
right angle. Yeah, you have perpendicular here, right?
Yes.
The height should be perpendicular to the base, which should join the vertex.
Yes.
The top vertex.
So
So here I took this as height, this as base. While writing it, I wrote it as half into the whichever order.
So
I wanted U to be first to make a pattern. U, T, V, T.
So how did you get B, sir?
So I'm talking about the triangle 2.
For triangle 2, this is the base.
Yes, sir. So that would be V minus 2.
No,
that
it starts here
that is B,
B,
and goes all the way till here.
That's B.
So see the length. This much length.
That
is B.
B, sir.
So base of this triangle is V.
So basically rectangle, opposite sides are equal in a rectangle.
Okay, you will understand it in different ways, no need to tell it and confuse others. Leave it. Yes?
Just come back to the question. So the base of V that I got,
but
only taken as the height.
Height is V. This is the base.
Then
what is the height of the vertex?
Which is T.
From the base.
T.
You have to draw a perpendicular from the vertex to the base.
Which is T.
That perpendicular would be parallel to this.
Yes.
And
so
the length will be equal. This length
is
time. So this is time. This is taken as base. This is taken as T. And its value is T.
So but
R is
two triangles then.
Kesher, if you have a triangle like this, if this is the base, okay? What is the height of this triangle so that we get half into half into base into height. How will I get the height from the vertex and draw the perpendicular?
Yes.
This
is the height.
Dividing the triangle to triangle.
Okay. Please, yaar, let him hear from one person at a time. So this line which I draw gives me the height of this triangle. Agree? Of course, when I draw it in the diagram, it looks like two smaller triangles. So, why does it confuse you? You don't have to bother about that. Area of this entire outer triangle is half into entire base multiplied by entire height. You could also find it as half into this base into this height plus half into this base into this height. That is same as half into total base into same height.
Third.
Now let's move on to third equation.
Can you move this instrument?
Not talk. We are racing against time.
Sir, can you move your mobile phone, sir? So I can't
yes,
see
yes.
The equation.
Please move around and sit. We are recording for your benefit.
So
if videos can be seen by you at a later time when you want. Okay, now third equation of motion. Let's derive it. So for third equation. We will find the area under the graph by adding the rectangle, the area of rectangle plus the area of triangle. Okay? Area of rectangle plus area of triangle. Let me draw it the same way. Okay? So area of triangle is half into time. Okay. So till here is clear, everyone? Now here in this V minus U, I will use this result. Can you do that? So V minus U is going to be replaced with 80. Yeah, substituting it. So it becomes half
into T into 80
into
80 squared
into T plus U.
This is half 80 squared.
UT plus
half
80 squared.
Square.
Very famous equation of
motion. So, one question, sir.
Number 3. Yes.
So, you're just finding the area of triangle plus
rectangle,
rectangle in the third. So, sir, is it possible that you use the trapezium, the area of a trapezium for this?
Same result you will get.
Same result.
You will get the same result. Different people think differently, there are different ways of doing the same derivations. If you understand something and if you have different way of doing it, provided it gives the same result, it's fine.
So why can't we just take half t common, half a plus u?
This is a more, what do you call it, easier way of saying it and sharing it with everyone.
So half a plus u is more easier, so you just have to
you do it like that. I don't mind.
No sir, I'll do it. This is not good. I was asking.
Everybody popularly Resides or narrates or it's not a big deal. Ut plus half and square is the way everybody speaks. So let's use it.
So
instead of having a bracketed term and then it's easier to remember also, I think. Ut plus half.
Half team A plus U bracket.
We are wasting time on unnecessary things.
So 1 minute.
Now one more fourth equation of motion is left.
Trapezium.
So just 2 minutes.
Wait, one more fifth is also there.
Okay,
sir.
Now fourth one. How can you find?
Wait, sir. Wait for a minute. Let us copy it.
Go
slow. Okay. While the others are writing, those who can listen, please listen and tell me.
Yes. So we'll miss out.
Please,
sir. We'll miss out.
That's unfair.
We'll miss out, yes.
Sir, why
should we miss out?
Late alone?
Yes.
Yes.
How much time is left?
20 minutes. 20 minutes.
Okay, we are going well on track. Shall we start now? Fourth equation, I will give you a chance to figure out.
The second one we use trapezium, half of sum of parallel sides into height.
Okay. Now for finding the fourth equation, see, what is the need for so many equations? The need
the same
is
same thing all equations.
No, there is a difference between each equation.
So you can use simultaneous equations.
In each problem which you solve in physics, right, related to this, you may be knowing different quantities and different quantities may be unknown. Suppose you know initial velocity, time and acceleration. And you want to find final velocity, you will use this. Suppose you don't know the acceleration, you only know initial and final velocity and time, then you will use this. Are you getting it? In different equation, different things are known. Are you getting it? Suppose you have a case where you want to find the displacement of the object, but you don't know the final velocity. You don't know the final velocity, you only know initial, acceleration and time.
And sir, we can even use
this. Now I will tell you a situation. You don't know the initial velocity, you only know the final velocity, acceleration and time. Then you can't use any of this, right?
VAD.
Okay, you could do it multiple steps. If you know final velocity, acceleration and time,
minus
you can
find
U.
So we can go into the problem simultaneously, we can solve it simultaneously.
But I want you to save your time and derive a ready-made, don't do anything.
Sir, so
may
I
have a question? Sir,
what I'm telling you is, derive a ready-made equation, okay, so that you don't have to do two steps. If you have only final velocity, acceleration, time,
yeah,
how will you find it? Displacement x.
So,
this is initial velocity, acceleration, time. Instead of initial, you have final.
You have final.
So, what if you know the displacement?
You don't know, you have to find. You know V, T, A.
So, V, U plus
A. You will use this first to find U, then substitute here and find x. I know that. Instead of wasting time to doing two.
I'll give you
the clue. To find you this equation, we this rectangle plus this triangle area we added.
Yes, sir.
Similar thing. Combination of two
so,
areas.
So, whole minus a triangle.
Very good. So, now what you do is outer red rectangle minus this triangle will give you the required area.
We will not use U there. We'll only need V.
So let me just do it. Do it now.
No sir, but we will use sir, V minus U height to lena padega.
Do it. No, you don't need V minus U.
No, you'll need delta V.
No need. So let me draw this red rectangle.
Minus a triangle.
Minus this triangle, we'll call it this.
So first modify the diagram, sir.
Okay.
Sir, remove the U lines, it's confusing.
Which line?
And those two figures. Now it's
good. Okay. So now fourth is displacement equals area of red rectangle minus area of this triangle. Agreed, everyone?
Great.
Everyone agrees with this step?
Yeah.
That is the required area. We want this area. This is the displacement.
Displacement.
Agreed. So big rectangle is breadth into length. So T multiplied by V. So VT. VT minus area of triangle is half into base is what?
So V minus Q, sir.
Half into T.
Sir.
Into
T. Since I told you we need you.
Okay.
Sir, so can we write T minus Q?
Now we will use from V minus U equals 80.
Yes.
We can do this.
We get X equals VT minus half 80 into T, which is VT minus half 80 into T. We know final velocity, we know initial velocity, we know acceleration.
Displacement
we have to find based on final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration.
1 minute, sir.
Right now all your equations have time in it. Suppose you don't know the time of travel, but you want to find displacement and you know everything else. We need one more equation.
So what is acceleration?
A.
No, in this graph.
Slope. So the final one, you have to use any of the earlier equations and eliminate time.
Half into base into it.
So let's, let me, can I erase this?
You haven't started the fifth one, right?
No. Yeah, fifth one I'm going to start.
Fifth one, so three new
one. Fifth one, you won't use graph.
We won't use the graph only.
You will use the earlier equations to
derive the point. On the point of the acceleration is correct.
Fifth one, goal is? You want x in terms of x should be a function of
a
u
v
and a only
u v a
no time